I'm planning on putting this bed together today. That's the ends. And that's the base. But it looks like his lord and master has got other ideas. So we'll wait to see if he decides to get up and go somewhere at some point. Because that's the position it's going in, right in that corner, underneath that window. Right in the center, underneath that window. Okay, we're going in that space there. I finally got his lordship to move. Well, he moved of his own accord, but I just started making a bit of noise there where he was sleeping, and he's moved on. So this is the bed. It is a sprung base, and these slats here have been added. There's an adjuster for the spring, and that's right there. So you just tweak him up here, spray a bit of spray on it, tweak him up, pull him tight. There's none at the other end, so this end here I'm going to have in that direction at the foot of the bed so that I can get to it. So that's the go there. Just going to lay him down right here on the floor and start assembling it. He's not happy. He's cranky. He wants his spot back. Hey, not getting it. All right, so I'll bring in a few other pieces. Obviously there is the ends, top and bottom. And we'll build it around that. I guess the first thing that has to happen is the base needs to go down on the floor. These rails. Go like that. It's silky oak.
another silky oak piece. Not very heavy. Build it over a bit. This over the top. Gee, that's low, isn't it? Gonna need a big spongy mattress on top of that. Now the end of this rail is here. So I guess I can push him up a bit. Some lugs. There's a lug there that it sits inside. And now my rails are sticking out the end. Perfect. So low. It's low as low. If I have to take the base off, I'll do that, but I want to try and get this up and in. sitting there. Got him. How hard was that? Baby boy, come, my baby. Hey, boy. It's a little bit hard. But I'll fit. I can fit on there. Baby. Boy, a muddy boy, funny, silly dog. No, muddy. Yeah, you boy, baby. Yeah. So I'll set this back up for the cat. This is just a very slim mattress that I got with a sofa bed that I bought, so it goes over the top. So this won't be permanent. It's the right size, it's a double. You know, that actually feels okay. I could sleep on that. I could sleep on that. How about this way? Sleep for 5 minutes and get woken up with a dead hip or something. Not perfect for my back. So there's no point stretching this wire with those slats there. But a nice big inner spring mattress about that tall. And then we're sort of getting up to around bed height. Well, that happened quicker than I expected. Let's get him centered, shall we? Double bed, 1,380. So I don't need to find the centre because it's there. It's just under this rail. You know, it might end up staying there. I was going to put it up the other end there with the other bit I got, but... I'll have to restore that one day. We'll see, huh? Job done, finished. Now I've got to find something else to do. Shall see. This is Kero from Camp Zero, Eastern Australia. Thank you for your time and patience on these past 8 videos to do with furniture removal. I'll see you on the next one, which may be about my car, I'm not sure. But in the meantime, have a great day, and I'll catch you on the next bit. Thanks for your time. Bye.
Check it out. It didn't take long. As you were. Bye.